We learned the Vatican cleared the former Archbishop of St. Paul in Minneapolis of committing a crime.
But the investigation found that former Archbishop John Nienstedt took imprudent action, and the church has banned him from working or living in the Twin Cities. Danny Spiewak joins us now with this major update on the case. Danny?
Randy and Julie, today's announcement came from the current Archbishop Bernard A. Hebda, who says he recently learned from the Vatican that his predecessor has been cleared of crimes under church law. But a lot of questions remain, dating back to when this scandal involving former Archbishop Nienstedt first broke a decade ago.
Justice, our song now.
In 2013, a crisis involving former Archbishop John Nienstedt exploded into public view when a whistleblower accused him of mishandling abuse allegations. Although he initially pledged to take action,
to provide safe environments for everyone in the church,
Nienstedt resigned in 2015 after the Ramsey County attorney brought criminal charges against the archdiocese. Those charges, later settled, faulted the church for failures involving a priest named Curtis Waymire, who went to prison for molestation.
A change in leadership offers us an opportunity.
In 2019, after Pope Francis introduced a stronger policy on abuse, the Vatican launched a broader investigation into Nienstedt's tenure and even allegations of inappropriate conduct specifically against him. Now we've learned the Vatican found no evidence of a crime under church law, and allegations against Nienstedt were deemed unfounded. The Vatican did find evidence of what they're calling imprudent actions, but won't elaborate further.
It's a blanket that covers everything. What's imprudent exactly?
Frank Muirs is among the Minnesota victim survivors who has made allegations against the church.
They investigate themselves, and they apply it to their own laws, and then they declare that no harm, no foul, and it infuriates people.
Despite not finding evidence of a crime, Pope Francis has banned Nienstedt from working or living in Minnesota and the Dakotas.
And that speaks volumes. You know, they so much do not trust him that they don't want him around.
Mike McDonald heads a National Abuse Survivors Network.
And that red flag tells us that there is definitely something more to this that the church does not want to be revealed.
We are told that Nienstedt currently lives in the state of Michigan. Through a spokesperson, he released a statement today saying that he has fully cooperated with all investigations and is sorry for any pain caused. He also says he's asking the Vatican for more clarification himself on those allegations of his, quote, imprudent actions. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Danny.